Hello everyone, I'm going to work on my free-formed yield again, and I'm going to work on the second layer, and I'm pouring some pale gold of just resin, a line, on top of the blue, the bleach blues of color art, and I want a little bit of gold on top of the bleach blues. And I'm also going to work on the third layer in some places. And in this layer I'm trying to create some depth, adding some details. Now, next to the pale gold, I'm pouring a line of Belize blues. Very thin line. And some clear next to it, so that it can flow into the clear. Because I don't want to cover the whole area, the whole dark violet area, only in some places. Now I'm pushing the resin against each other, that I don't have any gaps in it, so that it's all covered with resin. Heating it up with my heat gun, I have another attachment to it. And now I'm blowing against the pale gold. And I'm trying to blow it over the Belize blues, so that I get that wavy effect. And that's why I'm pouring the clear next to it, because then it can flow into the clear and lays it on top of the dark violet. There you can see it. Now again, I'm pouring a line of gold, but then on top of the aqua, the Bombay ink. And next to it, a darker version of the Bombay ink than I had in the first layer. I also mixed some FW ink in it, the sky blue, so that it gets another color, a darker one. But it's still transparent. And next to it, some clear. And again, I'm blowing with my heat gun against the gold, and I'm trying to blow it over the first layer. Now I'm filling in the gaps where there isn't any resin of the second layer, so that it's all filled. Yes, and I'm also going to add some glitter and maybe some mica flakes. Yeah, I lost some gold, so I'm adding another line of pale gold of just resin. All the materials I'm using are listed in the beginning of this video, but also in the description box with the links where I buy my materials. So if you want to see which one I use, then you can go to the description box and check that out. Yeah, and the geode looks a little bit darker than it is in person because of the lightning. But in the daylight it sparkles a lot, much brighter colors. Again, I'm filling in the gaps with some clear resin. But I need to watch out because the gold is still wet. It can flow a little bit into it, but not too much. Yeah, and this geode is going to have one more layer in the mold, and then I can, if that is dry, I can demold it or unmold it. So I'm very excited if it goes easy. Yeah, we will see. I hope it does. And that part where the green is, that is already the third layer. Also a little bit of clear over the fire glass and the glow in the dark stones. Now a little bit of glitter on top of the fire glass in the color jade. Very fine glitter. Gives it a little bit more sparkle. The torch for the air bubbles. And then I'm almost done for this part. And then I let it dry. And then I will work on it again. So it has dried for several hours and now I'm going to work on a third layer. I'm going to add a glitter line and I mixed two glitters together, the rose gold and the dark blue. And yeah, I'm pouring a line against the gold because I think it needs a little bit more sparkle. And I mix a lot of glitter in my resin so that it gets really thick. And then it doesn't spread too much to the sides. And again, I'm using small cups because then I have a little bit more control over over the line. Yeah, and it dried very well. I like the wavy effect what I created in the first part of this video. Again, some glitter against the fire glass in the color mint. That's the really fine glitter of Recollections. And I'm not sure if I'm liking the gold in the Belize blues. So, yeah, I need to think about it. If I want to change that in the next part or that I leave it in. But I find it a little bit dark. A little bit clear on top of my fire glass because I added a little bit more fire glass and also some glow in the dark stones. So I want to make sure that they stay in place. And now I'm pouring a line of clear resin on the dark violet. And I'm going to add some mica flakes, and I mixed some holographic glitter in it, in the purple color, blue-purple color. And I lay it on top of the line of clear resin. It gives a little bit more sparkle in the dark violet area. I like that. Yeah, this takes a little bit of time. But I'm almost done with the line. And now with my stick, I'm pushing the flakes in the clear resin and also the glitter to get the line a little bit straighter. Yeah, and after this is dried, I need to think about if I want to add more colors. Yeah, I'm a little bit thinking about the gold color in the green and the blue, if I like that or not. So yeah, we will see what I'm going to do. I find it a little bit dark, so maybe I'm going to add a lighter color, I don't know yet. But the mica flakes are very nice. They are very sparkly, and it gives you your geode a structure. I like that. It doesn't have to be all flat. So almost done with the line. On top of it, again a line of clear resin, not too much, only a little bit. Yeah, and after it is dry, then you can brush all the glitter that is not stuck on your geode, you can brush it off. Because otherwise, if you put your clear on top of it, then it will flow into the clear and then you have everywhere glitter. I don't like that. So almost done, and then I also have a close-up, so if you want to see that, then you can wait until the end of this video. So this is how it looks after a few hours of drying, and yeah, I'm still thinking about the gold in the Belize blue, if I like that or not, and in the green. So I need to think about if I want to change that or not. And the mica flakes are very nice. I like them a lot. And also the holographic glitter I mixed in it. It sparkles a lot. And also the wavy effects I have created in the blue, I like that also a lot, because the dark blue purple shines through, so you get some depth that way. Yeah, and I need to think about that gold I added. Maybe I will change it in a lighter color. A little bit closer. There you see the mica flakes, very nice. The glitter line, and there you see the wavy effect I created. It's nice. Sparkles a lot. There you can see the gold where I'm thinking about if I want to keep it or not. There you can see it sparkle a lot in the mica flakes. Gives it a nice structure. I also like the green a lot, the aqua and the fire glass. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up for this video, and you can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. The links to that sites are in the description box. If you have comments or questions, place them under the video or send me an email. Then I'll get back to you. And I want to thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.